a question and answer session. Chief Minister Naidu will now take questions. Ambassador Pillay will be moderating this session. Please line up behind the standing microphones to ask your questions. One is at the center and one is at the right.
Ladies and gentlemen, you have heard a very good presentation, and Chief Minister has said that he will answer all the questions. I had a request from a friend as I came in to say the moderator should not ask questions. Since I think there are going to be many questions, I will resist the temptation of asking the first question. Maybe I'll ask the last question if things don't work out as actively as I think.
No, okay. Your question, you have to answer. Because you are our ambassador.
Thank you very much, Chief Minister. The question I have, the person speaking, not just for Andhra, but for all of India. India takes a lot of pride in its democracy. Rightfully so. When 800 million people vote, they're a fantastic thing. It's not something to be treated as it's a joke. No. Without any incidents, without any problems in country, 800 million people vote in the last. Now, with that comes the noise and the everything else. Now, my question to you, Chief Minister, why do you want to maintain the tradition of democracy and you want to do things as democratically as possible? Sometimes this inhibits or constrains your hands in doing things for economic development. Various measures can be face severe constraints because you must follow very democratic system. And when you have 800 million people voting, you know, there's so much of diversity, there's so much of conflict of interest between groups. Chief Minister, Ankara with 50 million people and with one of the best educated population, your problems are not less but more. Because the more educated, the more articulate, the more thoughtful people are, the more questions and more objections that they will have. Every question will have several sides, not two sides. This point is called multi-faceted. So how are you going to keep this? Because even recently there was so much of politics in our that people were simple people from Singapore, they have trouble, who have fighting. We stay back and watch. Now how, what assurance can you give us that these are minor things that we will absorb and we will be able to
do? No, what I'm saying, human psychology all over the world is fake. Even Singapore is same, America is same, or India is same. But the leadership, they provide stable government and also administration and also motivation. In Singapore, they are able to motivate people for the last 5 decades. Because of that, there is a continuous development. Even there is no proper leader in Singapore, it will collapse over a period of time. It may not take much time also, 4 or 5 years is enough to completely collapse the economy. So that is where we are now. In India, now stable government has come. We are working on that. In Andhra Pradesh, as you rightly mentioned, one example I am giving you. In India, on land acquisition, there is a big issue is going on. Previous government has brought one land acquisition bill. In that bill, 70% farmers has to give consent. Then only you can go for land acquisition. 70% consent is impossible. Then the present government wanted to change and relax, but they need support. Same time I had a challenge. I want to go for land acquisition for capital. Then I announced the project. I told my people, this is a new capital, this is overall interest of the state, particularly if you give land, your land value will increase, capital will come, you are the first beneficiary. I introduce land pool. Those who are giving land voluntarily, after development of infrastructure building, I will give back 25% to 30% land to the farmer. All opposition parties came there. They demonstrated. People are giving willingly. They are instigating them not to give willingly. If you can understand, land acquisition at least they can oppose, but not voluntarily people are giving. How can I say? They say, don't give, it is a right. But people are having this. I am telling you, within the last 6 months or 8 months we have done, 33,000 acres of land people give voluntarily. Nowhere in democracy it has happened. It has happened in other places. That is how we are doing it. What I am saying, better than, bigger than this crisis anywhere, you can face it. This is the biggest crisis we are able to overcome. All other things is not an issue at all. Now our people are very good. I am motivating. What Singapore is doing, same thing I am doing. Very docile. And also law-abiding. And also very proactive. This is happening now. Even Bhogapuram. In the Visakhapatnam, one more airport is coming, Greenfield Airport. That airport also, in a big way, we want to develop. Like this, I am telling you, everything is possible. Even earlier, in Hyderabad, I developed within 9 years' time one of the best city. Recently, with all difficulties, now, just like private companies, I am also introducing how to calculate growth rate every quarterly. Generally, countries will do, not states. India will do once in 3 months. Every month also they will give some figures on industrialization. Now my state is doing the job. First quarter of second year, we are able to grow 9.72% growth rate in spite of some drought. Now all India growth rate is 7.1%. I am 100% confident next year, this year onwards, our growth will be double digit. We will start. So what I am saying, if you perform, if you focus, automatic results will come. Even I am telling you, in Singapore if you start free distribution, tomorrow you call people, you want to do free, there will be stampede. Psychology is saying, how to mold them, how to educate them, how to take them further and further, it depends upon leadership that is happening in India. As you rightly mentioned, our population will be our advantage if you motivate them properly. They will serve all over the world. That is the strength India is having. It is going to happen in the near future. I am totally optimistic. It is going to happen. You are going to see from now onwards, so many success stories from India. That is how things are happening.
Thank you. Now, open to the floor. Please mention your name. Make the question short so that maximum number of people can ask. May I have the first? Yes.
Hi, my name is Mani Kari. Thank you very much, sir. It was truly an inspiring talk, and I'm really happy to know that finally the processes are in place. And it feels very good to be outside and know that India is going to have a lot of success. And I've been to Hyderabad a few times for scientific talks and really enjoyed being there. So I have read in Hindu recently that you are advocating about people having more children in Andhra Pradesh so that it can be a young state. So my question is related to the education. And the question is that in 2007, Ministry of Women and Child Development said that Andhra Pradesh has highest number of sexually abused children along with Assam, Bihar and Delhi. So since we are developing the state so much, what are your views on that? Or would you be taking any help from Singapore or any other country who are already doing this kind of stuff and making their children empowered?
Thank you. As a matter of fact, Andhra Pradesh for the last 10 years, we suffered a very serious setback. Even what you are saying, that is one, abuse of children, crime, and also literacy levels. 1991, 2001, 10 years, when I was here, we are able to add 17% literacy within 10 years' time. These 10 years, they are able to add only 6%. Now, Andhra Pradesh, combined Andhra Pradesh, is 31st place on literacy. Like that, there are so many problems. Now, things are happening, as you rightly mentioned. I am taking up so many initiatives. Law and order is my priority. Even children, how to protect them, how to motivate them, we are working. Even best practice in Singapore, I am prepared to take the best practice and implement it. You will see, whenever there is a strong leader, things will happen automatically. Then if you behave properly, then results will come very fast. That is going to happen now. It's already started in all aspects. Not only one or two areas, every area there is improvement. In some of the areas there is a drastic improvement. It will happen this also. We are concentrating.
So would you like to make the body empowerment seminars for children as an integral part of curriculum for preschools?
Yeah, we'll do that also.
Thank you.
Yes.
Good evening, sir. Thank you for the inspiring speech and congratulations on all that you have achieved so far. You've been my hero since childhood.
Can you give me your name, please?
My name is Varad. I run a tech startup in Singapore. So my question or my request is like, you would have really thought about that. You haven't mentioned anything about developing entrepreneurship within the state, and what is the state going to do to actually help startups? You've gone through the top now, the Microsofts and the Googles. So what is that you have with you for the next Microsoft, Googles that are going to come up in the world?
Good question. Earlier also, even our people used to go to America and they used to work. Then I started. Why can't you start companies here? From there onwards, companies have come. They started here operations. And at the same time, I asked at the time, Indians are doing only job work. It is not correct. Go for products. That is how we promote it. So many Indian companies have come. Even some companies are working small, big, medium size, or all working all over the world. Now I wanted to promote in a big way small companies also. Small companies are having disadvantage of infrastructure. If I give infrastructure, proper infrastructure, you will do extremely well. That is where we are promoting. Second one, I wanted to make Andhra Pradesh Silicon Valley of India. That is where we are starting, already we have started startup villages, incubation centers. Every college, every school, high school will have incubation centers. Already I started, initiated this. Even venture capital, I am working in a big way. Those professional companies will come, I will give matching, and also I will give equity also. So that I want to encourage maximum matching. This is a very good exercise, not only IT companies. I want to go for incubation and also startup villages in so many areas, technology, science, everything. So even sometimes traction will come, even high school days also. Even that centers I am concentrating on. If you are having any interest, I am very happy. You start a small company in other days, we'll extend the cooperation.
Sure. Will there be special recognition for Singapore startups to come into?
Yeah, we'll do that.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. My name is Jayant Narayan, professor at US Business School. Short question, how are you balancing environmental concerns and sustainability issues? Because you're talking of single window clearance, you're talking of 21 day clearances. Can you do environmental assessments in 21 days on the infrastructure projects? How are you going to balance development and environment? Because if India and China consume like the US, we don't have a planet to live on.
What I'm saying, first of all, for sustainability, you have to balance environment. There is no doubt about it. If you see Singapore or Dubai, so many countries are using seafront in a big way. And at the same time, you are controlling pollution. In India, we are not using beach stop. There are so many regulations. But all our cities, affluents are going to see. That is the biggest challenge. So industry is 21 days clearance. Routine clearances will come. There is any environmental assessment, it will take some season, some time, all these things we are giving time. And of this Swachh Bharat, I am giving a report, how to go for waste to energy. That is one area we are working. So that as on today, if you see in towns, small towns, big towns, tons of wastage are lying on the roads and also lands, so much of pollution, underground water pollution, so much of smell, even sewerage, we are not treating properly. That's why that area is totally polluted. That type of problems we are facing as a developing country. We have to treat that. We have to go in a big way for plantation, green cover. If you see Singapore, town is full of greenery. Even they are buried. Neighboring countries like Indonesia, there is a fire, the smoke, all this thing, pollution is coming here. So this is where countries are concentrating. I'm also doing a big way for green cover. As on today, we are having only 24-25%. I want to take 40-50% green cover. So everything I'm concentrating on environment for sustainability. I'm assuring you that.
Yes, like everyone said before, very inspiring talk. I have two short related questions. So my name is Madhu Prada and I'm a PhD student here. So it is universally known that a lot of young students go outside of India for higher studies, and a large number of these youths come from Andhra. So I wanted to ask you, what encouragement, what steps are you going to take to retain these students back in Andhra so that you can use their knowledge, their education, help them educate more in higher studies and use them as your knowledge capital? That's one question. And the related question is, I'm a researcher myself. I'm in the biomedical research field. So what, again, steps would you be taking to enhance opportunities or infrastructure for biomedical or biotechnology research in Amravati or elsewhere in Andhra Pradesh?
Thank you. Thank you. One is on education. All our people are coming, are going all over the world. That is the biggest challenge. Here in America, majority universities, both professors and also students are from India. Same professors and students will be in India, there will be tremendous economy, growth in economy. So what I'm thinking, even all of this, earlier I started so many institutions of excellence. ISB public-private partnership, even IIIT, even NALSA, even Urdu University, like there are so many institutions, high schools, international schools we started. Now, Government of India, because of bifurcation, they have given IIIT, IIT, ISER, NIT, even Central University, Tribal University, this type of universities they have given. Now I want to make Andhra Pradesh as a knowledge state and education hub. Three cities are making education hubs, mega cities, Visakhapatnam, Amaravati, and Tirupati. And all other areas also, I'm going in a big way for education. Even private universities bill, I brought it, I'm getting very soon. So the top 10 universities in the world, top 10 universities in the country, private universities, I want to invite them for setting up their branches there, or separate university. People are showing so much of interest on that. This is one way, I told you, when I was CM, earlier 1995, we had 30 engineering colleges. Within 8 years time, 9 years time, I increased to 300. from 6 or 7 medical colleges, science is 30. That is how things happen. Education is very key. Even we want to go for research also in a big key. That education front, we are very clear, we will achieve it. Long back I conceived, after information technology, we have to concentrate on biotechnology. In Hyderabad Genome Valley, I created at that time. Even ICICI, all these people, they started. It is doing very well. Now, same thing we are going to start in New City and also in Sakra. These two areas on biotechnology, we are going to concentrate. Thank you.
Blue shirt.
My name is Shiv Divan. I have a chemical plant in Andhra. I've been there for 25 years. I just want to share my experience. During the time when Chandrababu Naidu was the chief minister, he probably had the best years. After he left, we had 4, 5 terrible years where we didn't have power for 30 to 40% of the time. And when he took over in May, he promised that by October we would have 100% power, and that's what he delivered. I just want to emphasize what he said, that it's the leadership that provided. I'm a living example of what I have experienced in Andhra. So I just wanted to share that.
Thank you.
Power is the most dreaded and the most draining of our internet. We are a continuous process industry, which virtually killed us within 4 months. I don't know what magic he did. Obviously, there was power. What was lacking was the management capability. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. This is one example I took for you. When I took over as CM, there was a shortage of 22.5 million units. Then with my experience, I introduced the power sector reforms also I started in the country. Then I called here only my Ajay Jain is here, his secretary power. Then I called him, we discussed. Then I guided them. Where is the problem? Then our PL, plant load factor is 70% or 65%, 70%. Immediately I increased to 85%, 90%. Previously there is a lack of coordination and also no coal. Because of coal, they used to shut down plants. All industries have become sick, as rightly mentioned. So much of small-scale industries, so many lakhs and lakhs of people are becoming unemployed, and also industries have become sick. Within 15 days, I streamlined. Some power I purchased in the initial stage. Now I am very clear, we are power surplus. Never will have a problem of power from now onwards. Even government of India selected Andhra Pradesh 24/7. There is one state in South India. I can give you quality power. Reliable power. Forever there won't be any problem in the power sector. That is how we made it within 1 month's time or 1.5 months' time. Now, with all these things, I'm concentrating on quality and also theft and technical losses. Now I can say very proudly, our state is 10.3 or 10.4% technical and also commercial losses. This year we will reach single digit. Next 2-3 years time, we will reach 5-6%. It is for international standards. You go to America, it is 5-6%. You come to Andhra Pradesh, it will be 5-6%. Even Singapore standards will reach smart grid, power grid. All these things we are going to establish. As the technology is available, as a matter of fact, we are having better technology compared to America because there is an integration problem with new technology and old technology. We can go brand new. All my 10,000 feeders, I already put it online. Anybody wanted to see from Singapore, some unit in Andhra Pradesh, how power is flowing, you can see online. That is how we are using technology. So this is one example, as rightly mentioned, we have overcome. Like that, so many things, everywhere I am streamlining administration. I am using technology in a big way. Another thing I am telling you on technology, every month we are giving around 42, 43 lakh pensions for poor people, 1,000 rupees per month. And also physically handicapped, 1,500 rupees per month. I have given tabs. The concerned person, along with the village committee, has to go to his residence, take his fingerprint or iris. He has to deliver door delivery. Real banking at his doorsteps. That is how we are doing. Then we are having Jan Dhan program. Those who wanted to take money, they can take. Or you want to save money, real time you can deposit his cash account, bank account. That also we are introducing. So everything, even e-pass, we are introducing a public distribution system. In a family, you have to go to the fair press shop. Then you have to authenticate his fingerprint or anything. Then you will get ration. Because of this, I am able to save nearly 1,000 crores for a year only on one program, that is public distribution. Poor people, what we are giving rice and other essential products. Huge self-reach. By using technology, we can tighten it, we can correct it, and at the same time, that money we can use for other development. It may be for toilets, it may be for the roads, it may be for other infrastructure. Money is available. India is not rich. All of us made India as poor. There is so many opportunities, so much of resources. If we tackle properly, things will happen. Please. Please. Louder.
Yes, sir. Hello.
Oh, please.
Yes, sir. My name is Ganga 13.
You can take mic with you. Can? Okay.
Yes, sir. First, thanks, sir, for giving this opportunity. And I have two requests from my side, sir. Are you starting?
Yeah. Louder.
Yes, sir. I have two requests from my side, sir. The first thing is, please take care of your health, sir. You are my hero. Yes, sir. You are my hero. Chandrababu Naidu is not only the CM of Andhra Pradesh, sir. Chandrababu Naidu is the name. It's a strength for the middle class people, parents. Chandrababu Naidu is a name. Middle class parents are the dhairyam, sir. Andhra Pradesh people. So please take care of your health, sir. And the second request is, I have a little bit of knowledge, but as per my knowledge, as per my observation, you are the master in disaster management and crisis management, which the examples are the Hulur or Uttarakhand, whatever it may be. Sir, if time permits, please make it as a book, sir. It would be very helpful for future generations. Because even the PhD persons who need PhD on the disaster management and crisis management, they won't have the knowledge like you, sir. I believe, I don't know that I believe. So, please, if time permits, please try to make it as a book, sir. It would be very helpful for future generations.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
What is suggesting is family. I introduce education in a big way, especially information technology, all the things. Now lakhs and lakhs of people are working all over the world. Earlier I used to go to everywhere. In airports nobody, I never used to meet anybody. Now so many people are working. They are coming and they are going. If you go to airport, hundreds of people are waiting for going other places, transit halls. This is when area where all middle class families are becoming very good, and at the same time, knowledge has given them very good opportunity to work overseas. Second aspect is rightly mentioned. We had one cyclone in the recent past. This 1 year I had that problem also. In Visakhapatnam, Udur cyclone, very bad devastation. With precautions, I was able to save so many lives. It is only nominal, but loss is very huge. And also total infrastructure totally destroyed. I had a very tough time in 3 districts. I was there only in a bus. There is no place for me in collectorate also to function. Then I was in bus for 1 week, 8 days. Within 8 days, I brought normalcy, total normalcy. And after bringing normalcy only, I left that place. That is how we handled. As the director mentioned, in future also, on disaster management, how to mitigate all these things, we are taking all precautions, we have with experience, we are still learning. We are preparing manual also on that. How to manage, whenever there is a disaster, how to manage, we are preparing disaster management book, manual. That manual will be useful for others to manage, how to manage, how to take precautions. Thank you.
I'm Professor Jolly from the National University of Singapore. Thank you for the great presentation. It is really giving a great hope for the Andhra Pradesh, which we have been probably not finding it in the last 2 years. I have one simple question. There is no world-class university in India, but there is no world-class university without Indians. And I would like to check from you, what is being done by the Andhra Pradesh government to attract the Indian talent back to India and build the world-class universities? Thank you.
Thank you. Now it is with you. I am asking what you are going to contribute, how you are going to contribute. I am preparing you all incentives. You have to bring Singapore University to Amaravati. That is one area where I am asking. I am constituting a committee, expert committee, just like Chaudhary. There are so many people. They are working all over the world, starting in Stanford or Harvard, Oxford, everywhere. I am networking with all these people. Then ultimately, I am inviting people to come and set up their universities also, best universities, top 10 in the world, top 10 in the country. So that I want to make all of this a knowledge state. Even I am requesting all professors, you have to come as visiting professors. In Tirupati, I created one of the best alternative program. Come as visiting professor. Be our guest, Tirupati Devasthanam guest for 1 week. Finally, you will have free darshan and also blessing from Balaji. That is the best package. Even money-wise, you are well off, but you must have satisfaction. So, 1 week you serve, then you take blessings, then you can go and work anywhere in the world. That is how we are working, how to network. Even earlier in Puttaparthi, Sai Baba used to do, so many people all over the world used to come to Puttaparthi for working in hospital and also for colleges, voluntary service.
Yes. Good evening, sir. My name is Anand, and I have been interpreting. My name is Anand. Can I check with you, how many security guards were accompanying you today? How many security guards were accompanying you today?
Yeah.
Yes.
I know why you ask. Singapore is Singapore. India is India. That is the problem. In Singapore, no need to have security. Everybody is safe and secure. In India, security has become an ornament. That is the biggest problem. In Singapore, policing is visible. Police are not visible. In India, police are visible, policing is not visible. If you do anything, straight away they will come and catch you. That is the beauty of Singapore. Same thing we have to be. That is where I am also working in the direction. Okay, thank you.
Good evening, Chief Minister, and good evening, Ambassador. Can you hear me?
Yes.
Louder.
Testing. Good evening. Good evening, Chief Minister. Good evening, Ambassador. I was saying that in order to achieve all your plans and your goals, you need quality human capacity, capability. Not just in excellence at the university level, but also excellence in basic education, post-secondary education, technical education, polytechnics, ITIs, and a whole level of skills that are needed to get to where you want to be. So my question is, what are your plans to improve the quality of schools, of teaching, of teachers, and technical and vocational education in Andhra Pradesh?
No, thank you. That is where India is lagging behind. One is education, and also quality education, and also skill development. These are all the areas we are having problems. Now I am concentrating on quality education, primary, secondary, and also vocational education. And also there are some illiterates, even that also we have to concentrate, then only 100% literacy will achieve. Apart from that, skills are very, very important. Even all of us, including me, I am working with a 20%, 25% efficiency. There is scope by using technology, by having vision, by providing leadership. Not only I work, then things will happen. I have to prepare teams. How to build capacity? That is the biggest constraint in India. There are some officers, they are working. But there are so many people, they cannot work. Some people want to work, they don't have capacity. Some people, they don't want to work, naturally they won't work. Some people are working, they are very small in number. They are not making any difference. That is the biggest challenge we are having. So I wanted to improve capacity building. Now capacity building, if you do, 4 or 5 people will do, then success stories will come, then everybody will have a confidence. Recently with 2-3 success stories, I have done one, that is industries. We are number 2 in the country now. For Andhra Pradesh and Gujarat, there is only 1% difference. From Andhra Pradesh, other states, Jharkhand and small state, there is 8-9% difference. There are some states, 30% difference with Andhra Pradesh. So this is where, when we announced this, all our people got confidence. One more thing I have done within 5 months, 20 days. From Godavari to Krishna, water linkage I started. March 29th, I laid the foundation, that is lift irrigation. 80 TMs of water we had to lift, 24 pumps, and also 177 km of canal, some already dug it. Then immediately I started. On war footing I have done. First pump we have inaugurated recently, that is on 20th. Exactly 1 month, that is 5 months, 20 days, we are able to complete first pump. This is a history. All these years people used to talk about water linkage, how our river linkages. We had a very big plan from Ganga to Godavari, Kaveri link. It didn't happen. When I completed it, people got confidence. People are talking. Not only in Andhra, all India, everybody is talking. River linkage is possible. It is not an impossible task. These 2 nations have given excellent advantage of bureaucracy. Now every secretary is talking. No, not only they, I am also performing. Next quarter, I am going to produce my results. This is where you have to inspire. And also, wherever there is a problem, how to upgrade skills, how to give proper techniques. This is where training, brainstorming sessions, and also going on like this, meetings, these are all the things we have to do. We'll do that.
Last question. Chief Minister, sir, my name is Charles Sharp, Eastwood School in Singapore. One question. It's nice to hear that you're doing all the best, getting the best. Question now is, what are you doing to the heritage of Andhra Pradesh? How you're preserving the aroma of Andhra Pradesh and all your wonderful developments? Thank you. heritage. How is heritage?
Heritage is
heritage of Bangladesh.
How you present
knowledge about yourself, right?
Yes. Yes. No, we are all thinking heritage means it is useless properties. That is the biggest problem for all of us. We have to protect heritage for future generations. It is our culture, it is our history. We have to protect it, we have to pass on to our future generations. Nowadays, not only that, it has become a very good tourism spot also. If you properly display, I am seeing Europe, not big properties, some properties, they will beautifully protect it and promote the properties. It has become one of the best tourism hubs. In Andhra Pradesh also, Amaravati, excellent temple is there. There are some, we can say, so many years back, I didn't have right now, some important evidences are shifted to England Museum also. We have to bring that type of issues. There are excellent ports, there are excellent buildings, there are some heritage monuments. I want to protect all these things. We are protecting now. We will take further precautions to protect this type of properties. And also, you are having any ideas on that, you can pass on to me. That also will take into consideration for doing a better job. With all these things, I am very happy. So many people are here. Again and again, I am assuring you, our government is very keen to promote investment. And also, we want to go in a big way for inclusive growth rate. Not only development should be meaningful. It should be inclusive growth rate. And at the same time, we are having around 80 lakh women members in our self-help groups. This one experiment earlier I had done. They are very, very dynamic, very, very creative. That ecosystem is working very well. If you give a message, within 1 hour they will have a everybody meeting and also they will come back with their resolutions, what all you say, they are prepared to act. They are all very, very cool. I want to eradicate poverty through these groups. That's the biggest exercise I'm doing as a social responsibility. So technology is very handy. By network, even online, even these chakra groups are producing so many products. Now we are going to market through Amazon.com or Flipkart, so many online organizations we are using. And also we are creating some more shops and skill development we are doing. Now they are having 14,000 crores as partners. I have given some money. Earlier they are able to save some money. I can borrow 1:5 ratio, around 60,000 crores or 70,000 crores. If I borrow 60,000 crores, then 1:2 production output or turnover, that means 1 lakh crores worth of business they can. If they earn 10% of profit, then that will be the money, 10,000 crores per year. So that is where we are working with all these groups. So I'm doing different experiments and also different projects. And everywhere I'm upgrading skills, I'm broadening leadership, and also I'm going low-hanging fruits, wherever it is possible, I want to produce results. Then short-term, medium-term, long-term, I am planning, and also scientifically on growth parameters and also public satisfaction and the human angle and also human indicators, social indicators, economic indicators, all these things we are balancing. With this experiment, I am very happy. I want to request all of you, seeing this belief, come and stay as our guest for one or 2 days in Andhra Pradesh. Then you are convinced, then only you can invest. That is my request. I am thankful to you for a wonderful evening, excellent support from all of you. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you, Chief Minister. I said earlier on that Singapore places its faith in Andhra because of the leadership of the state. I think today, the Chief Minister has proven or has given sufficient information to substantiate that belief that we have. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me to once again applaud him for his honesty.
Thank you, Chief Minister Chandrababu Naidu and Ambassador Gopinath Pillai. This brings us to the end of the interactive session. On behalf of ISAS, thank you for being here with us tonight and have a pleasant evening.